Luca ist so ein netter Junge.
Jop.
Ah, das sieht aus nach Endraum.
Where is this? This place is very different from the narrow hallway. Did we finally reach the deepest part of the pyramid?
Sphinx is supposed to be in the deepest part of the pyramid.
Sarah explains as she walks around restlessly.
What the?
A grave wind surrounds my body. Something crazy is nearby.
Uh-oh. You finally reached here, oh weak humans.
Oh, wie geil ist das denn?
An extremely strong-looking monster appears in front of us.
Ach, du heiliger Bimbam.
The sense of power coming off her was leagues above the previous monsters. Leagues of English. I don't think I'd be a match for her as I am now.
Are you Sphinx? Indeed. I am the master of the pyramid. I am the judge that watches over the deaths of those who would attempt the Dragon Seal trial. So if you're the final judge of the trial...
Sarah und dann wieder Sphinx.
Correct. If I deem you unworthy, I shall swallow you whole. Do you still wish to continue?
Eh? That would be a problem. I don't want to deal with this trial, I just want to save the princess.
Excuse me, could I ask a question?
I have no reason to answer your questions. The only thing I will acknowledge from you is whether you are taking the trial or not. If you aren't going to take it, leave at once.
I understand. I'll take it. So she won't even acknowledge me if I'm not taking the trial. I guess I'll have to go along with it then.
So what is the final trial? Do we have to fight you? It is not possible for a mere human to beat me. It would be a pointless trial if the final task was impossible. What am I supposed to do then? The final trial is a test of your mental power. You must answer my riddles. I prefer the wise. Fools deserve to be nothing but food.
Riddles?
Thinking things through is not my strong point.
Sarah, is this going to be okay?
Of course. Probably. I studied a lot growing up after all.
All right. I'll count on you then.
Sarah and I turn towards the things as we await her first question.
Yeah.
Uh-oh, können wir hier auch sterben?
Wenn wir falsch antworten, dann geht sie auf uns los.
Oh, Backe.
Und sie hat recht. Wir können sie nicht besiegen.
Okay. Now I ask of thee. What goes on four legs at dawn, two at noon and three at dusk?
Das übliche Rätsel. Prost!
Stimmt.
Such a widely known riddle is a final trial? Even I've heard of this one before. I shout out before Sarah.
Das Gute ist sogar, und das Logische, es gibt multiple richtige Antworten.
Okay.
Denn wenn man mal anguckt, wir haben die Möglichkeiten der Mensch, was natürlich die einfachste Antwort ist oder die geläufigste. Hm. Wir könnten sagen, ich, und da Luca ein Mensch ist, trifft es ebenfalls zu und ist richtig.
Genau.
Und die letzte Antwort wäre natürlich falsch, weil sie geht garantiert nicht auf zwei Beinen irgendwann mal.
Hm.
Also ich würde sagen Mensch, einfach das Übliche.
Also Human, ja?
Ja.
Okay.
Der Mensch, a Human.
Even a child has heard that one.
That was easy. Wait, was the riddle a trick?
Correct. Four as a baby crawling. Two as an adult walking. Three as an elder supported by a cane. Not that I needed to explain to someone who answered correctly.
The Sphinx iris narrow. Was that really the final trial? That was kind of anticlimactic.
Ich speichere zwar, aber ich glaube nicht, dass es nötig wird. Ich habe die Fragen noch halbwegs im Kopf, glaube ich.
Sehr gut. Then we shall proceed with the next question. Why am I asking you riddles?
Sehr gut, Luca wird's durchziehen. Luca lässt sich nicht beirren, egal wo wir sind. Er macht's immer wieder.
Er bleibt seiner Linie treu.
Oh ja. The trial isn't over yet?
Do you know the answer, Sarah?
Punkt, Punkt, Punkt.
Sarah slowly shakes her head no. Besides, what the hell kind of riddle is this? Isn't she just asking us about her own personal motive? No matter how smart Sarah is, how could she know what Sphinx is thinking?
Zungenbrecher, ahoi.
Yep, vor allem mit dem Bierintus.
Ja.
Why is she asking us riddles? To understand man's transience. Um den menschlichen irgendwas zu verstehen. Ich glaube, das menschliche Wesen heißt das irgendwie sowas in der Art. Weil du Rätsel magst? Oder ist das eine schlechte Angewohnheit? Ich glaube, es gehen die ersten beiden Antworten.
Also wenn ich das Spiel nicht kennen würde und dich jetzt nicht an meiner Seite hätte, dann würde ich zum ersten tendieren. Scheint mir irgendwie am plausibelsten zu sein, aber ich nehme das, was du nimmst.
Nehmen wir mal das erste und gucken, ob das, was sie dazu sagt, weil ich glaube, wir bekommen eine lustige Reaktion, wenn wir das zweite sagen. Das können wir gleich mal austesten. Es hat irgendwas mit dem Verstehen des menschlichen Daseins zu tun. If I remember right, my mother told me a riddle like that a long time ago.
That's correct, boy. The life of a human is frail and short, yet mine is so long.
The Sphinx's face slowly turns sorrowful. Also doch gut geantwortet. Dann laden wir, guck mal, ich lade mal ganz kurz neu, ich will wissen, was sie sagt, wenn wir vom schlechten Angewohnheit reden. Ich glaube, das ist auch richtig gewesen. Skippity Skippus und because you like riddles? Nee, oder? Ja, jetzt ist die Frage, was ist die lustige Sache? Ist das, weil es eine schlechte Angewohnheit ist oder weil sie Rätsel mag? Jetzt bin ich gerade überfragt. Was würdest du sagen?
Ich bin mir unschlüssig. Warte mal, ich guck mal, dass ich das auch nochmal geladen kriege.
Ich würde sagen, weil es eine schlechte Angewohnheit ist.
Ach, ich habe jetzt das Falsche geladen. Ich weiß nicht. Ich warte mal.
Sonst nimm den Skip-Button, der geht ja sauschnell eigentlich.
So, nee, ich habe das jetzt. So, jetzt habe ich es vor mir. Ich glaube, wenn ich jetzt einmal... Ach so, jetzt hier. Ich glaube, das Letzte würde das Lustigste hervorbringen. So.
Versuchen wir das mal.
Das Letzte, ja?
Ja, ja. Es ist eine schlechte Angewohnheit.
Okay.
It's just a bad habit of yours?
Sure. What an interesting response, boy. I don't even know myself if it's just a habit of mine now. I've asked that question to everyone who has come before me. For hundreds of years, nobody has ever responded with that.
Punkt, Punkt, Punkt. My careless answer seems to have made the Sphinx laugh. Is this good or bad?
This isn't quite the answer, but I shall accept it. Perhaps it is a habit after hundreds of years. After that man died for so long.
The Sphinx's laughing face slowly turns sorrowful. Gut, dann geht das also auch durch. Und jetzt kommen wir zur letzten, interessantesten Frage von dem ganzen Bunch.
Now the final question. In other words, this shall decide everything.
Punkt, Punkt, Punkt. Sarah and I both hold our breath. Finally, the last question.
Why are you taking this trial?
Eh?
Oh! Luca und du, ey, ihr seid echt beste Freunde, wie mir scheint.
Ja, wenn ich mit dem Saufkumpan irgendwo in eine Bar gehen würde, ich sag dir, wir würden ins Koma fallen.
Ich glaube, der wird irgendwann eins aufs Maul bekommen oder so von dir.
Ja, auf jeden Fall. The last question is, why we're taking the trial? Isn't that more like an interview question? Can I even answer this? Should I answer honestly? Ich wurde mit hineingezogen, die ehrliche Sache. Für Liebe und Frieden.
Ich glaube, beim zweiten würde sie uns voll auslachen. Ich glaube, das würde sie uns nicht abkaufen.
Das glaube ich auch. Und die Antwort, die auf jeden Fall sie nimmt, weil es eine der richtigen ist, das weiß ich, ist die dritte, nämlich, dass wir es Sarah überlassen sollen zu antworten, denn schließlich ist sie hier reingekommen und wollte die Prüfung machen, zum Teufel. Wie wir es von den ganzen anderen Monstern vor der Sphinx sagen wollten eigentlich.
Also nehmen wir jetzt die drei?
Ja, würde ich einfach mal sagen.
Okay.
Weil das ist auch die beste, finde ich, Variante von den Text, der jetzt kommt. I'll leave it to you, Sarah.
Guck mal, Luca färbt schon total ab.
Ja.
Me?
Sarah has a blank look on her face.
Do you not have an answer? If you do not give me your reason, I shall not acknowledge you.
To begin with, I didn't come here to take the trial.
I came here for another reason, but decided to go with Sarah. That's why I don't have the ability to answer your question. The one who should answer is Sarah.
If your words are true, then I shall ask the girl. Why are you taking this trial? I'm sorry, but I can't give a good reason. I'm just doing this to get closer to the one I love. Punkt, Punkt, Punkt.
Things fall silent as Sarah's words.
What? Is that not good enough? Would for honor or for justice have been better?
Why would you hesitate to answer with that? This dragon seal trial is intended to be for marriage between man and monster. However, none have attempted it thus far with that as their reason. So far, the desire for the riches contained in this pyramid have been their goal. Are you truly taking this trial in the name of love? 4 legs at dawn, 2 at noon, and 3 at dusk. That is, a human. Nobody actually thinks about the meaning of this riddle. Attempting to marry a monster, do you not realize the fatal flaw, the short-lived nature of man?
In other words, even if a human marries a monster, they will never live as long as their partner.
Correct. It is inevitable that the monster will be forced to watch their partner die. The human may have had a satisfactory life, but the monster will be forced to live on separated from their love for far too long.
Well, that... Wait, are you talking about yourself?
1,000 years ago, I loved a human. He was the hero Tsubasa, the emperor of the Burning Sands.
Eh?
The first king?
Correct. Our child became the next lord of Tsubasa Castle. For generations, the descendants of our child have ruled over this land.
So that's what happened.
I have heard that monster blood was mixed in the royal family.
That monster was Thinx?
My love slowly aged as I could do nothing but watch him die. I wanted to use my magic to turn him into a monster to prolong his life, but he refused. He wished to face his death as a human. We were together until his death. Then I was alone. It was possible for me to die as a human. There is power in this world that can seal a monster as a human. If I used that, I could have met death together with him. But I did not. I was scared of death. If my love and I both die, none would remember him in this world. Having every memory of his vanish from this world terrified me. Thus, I was separated from my love by death. For 1,000 years, I have been alone. Your name was Luca, was it not? You also hold a strange fate. If it was you, what would you have chosen?
Eh? Yeah, yeah. Me?
Safe Location, hey, wir dürfen noch antworten.
Mhm.
Ich hoffe, sie frisst uns nicht deswegen jetzt.
Na, ich hoffe auch nicht, die Musik ist aber so traurig. Ich glaube, sie mag uns, oder?
Ja, momentan geht's um ihr Schicksal. Wir können jetzt wohl aussuchen, was wir anstelle von dem Helden Tsubasa damals getan hätten. Und es ist jetzt wirklich nur eine Story-Antwort. Hätten wir weitergelebt, getrennt durch die Liebe beim Tod, wie es bei der Sphinx genauso war, zusammen in Liebe gestorben oder beide als Monster weitergelebt?
Ich weiß nicht, ich würde zwischen 1 und 3 schwanken. Also 2 würde ich ausschließen, aber bei den anderen weiß ich nicht.
Was würdest du tun?
Ich jetzt als real existierende Person?
In dem Szenario, ja.
3.
Nehmen wir das mal.
Okay.
I would have lived on together as monsters.
I also considered forcing him to live on as a monster against his will. But he was a very proud man. To trample over that, I would have trampled his existence itself. I could not do such a thing. Should I have placed his life over his pride?
She casts her sad gaze towards Sarah.
For one who loves a monster, the true trial is ahead. That is all I wish to say. I understand. I will never forget your pain. When I am bound together with Gran Beria, what will I do? When the time comes, I won't forget this.
I won't forget either. In a world where man and monster exist together, her story is critically important.
You two have passed the trial. Now I shall present you with a proof of your accomplishment.
Eh?
Das kann zwar echt nie sein. Wir bräuchten echt so einen E-Counter, ja.
Ich könnte es noch einbauen am Ende, aber dann müsste ich die ganzen vorigen Folgen nochmal durchgehen. Heiliger.
Das ist eine Menge Arbeit, oh ja. Vielleicht für Teil 2 oder so, wenn es da auch sowas gibt.
Das könnte man machen, ja.
Suddenly, a small emblem of a dragon floats over the back of my head for a few seconds before making a mark in my skin.
What was that?
It seems as though the same emblem appeared over Sarah's head. I didn't particularly care about completing the trial, though.
Ah! I completely...
Immerhin nicht eh.
Sehr gut. I completely forgot. The kidnapped princess was taken here.
I know nothing about that. I'm the master of the pyramid. I know everything that happens here. There is no kidnapped princess here.
Eh? Oh! Ich bin doch wahnsinnig.
Wir sollten vielleicht die Regeln überdenken oder so.
Ich glaube langsam auch.
The princess of Sabaza, she should be here.
What the hell are you talking about?
Sarah suddenly starts shouting at me. What's wrong, Sarah? Do you know something?
The princess of Sabaza. Is me.
Ach, ja, jetzt konnte ich dem eh grad gar keine Beachtung schenken, weil ich gerade so einen Aha-Effekt hatte. Oh, ach, du Schreck. Na, das ist ja ein Ding.
Luca!
Ich würde mal sagen, auf Ex, ne? Egal, wie viel da noch drin ist.
Ja, die halbe Buddel ist noch da. Nein, ich brauche die noch für später. Heilige Mutter. Heilige Elias, bitte befreie mich von Lukas' Ass. My eyes open wide as I stare at her in surprise. 3 days ago, a monster broke your window and kidnapped you?
I kicked out the window of my room and snuck out of the castle. My father would never have allowed me to come here.
A single word was left in horrible, hate-filled writing? Pyramid?
It's true, I left a message with my destination. But what the hell is with horrible, hate-filled? Is my handwriting really that bad?
So you left the castle on your own free will?
I thought there might be an issue in not coming back for 3 days. But they thought I was kidnapped?
To think, I was right next to the princess the whole time. I sigh as the power drains from my body. After all that fighting, I could have been finished right from the start.
The issue seems to have been resolved. I shall bestow this upon you as well.
Sphinx holds out a beautiful translucent yellow gem.
This gem looks familiar.
That's right. When I defeated those bandits, I got a red one that looks similar. Other than the color, it's identical.
That is a magical item called the Yellow Orb. Though it has been kept in this pyramid, it's no longer amusing to stop thieves and others from attempting to steal it. Therefore, I shall give it to you.
I'm not interested in magical items. Take it, Luca.
Ey, wann kommt aus dieser blöden Pyramide endlich raus?
Ich hab langsam echt Bauchweh vom Lachen, ey. Es ist der helle Wahnsinn.
You don't mind? Then I'll take it. I don't know if it's useful, but it couldn't hurt to take it. Wir haben den Yellow Orb, den zweiten von ich weiß nicht wie vielen.
Yeah.
It looks like I have 2 of these orbs now, but I don't know what to do with them. Hey, Sphinx, what is this orb used for?
It's used to revive the Holy Wings, but you need all 6.
Okay, 6 Stück.
Sell it or use it as an ornament. Do what you wish with it.
Ah, I see. I don't really get it. I put the strange gem into my bag.
I said I have lived in solitude and regret for years, but now I see it was not in vain. After 1,000 years, I can once again see the flame that burned bright in his eyes. In you, Sarah. In me?
Since Sarah is a princess, she must be a descendant of Sphinx. Seeing something that reminds her of her lover after 1,000 years must be shocking for her.
Now farewell, humans. Like him, continue to live a noble life.
Joop, und sie verschwindet einfach. Leaving that final message, Sphinx vanishes.
Even after 1,000 years, she still loves him. That's amazing.
Yeah. The sad story is still leaving me short of words. But I'm glad the princess is safe. It was a pointless quest after all. You weren't even kidnapped.
It wasn't pointless. I hate to say it, but without you, I never would have made it this far. Thank you.
I guess it wasn't all a waste to come here. Sarah narrows her eyes as she looks at the emblem on the back of her hand.
Please wait, Granberia. I meet you again soon for sure.
Are you going to meet her? At the Monster Lord's castle?
That would be the best place to start, for sure. But I heard that she was recently in Eliasburg. I wonder if she's still around here somewhere. Ah, I hope she comes to Sabasa Castle.
Nah. If she came, the castle would be in even worse shape.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, let's get out of here. There's nothing left for us to do in here.
That's true. Then I trust you to escort me, little hero.
I guess she is a princess after all. Could this be interpreted as a hero saving a princess? It's not quite what I imagined. We walk out of the pyramid as I try to think of how to interpret the result of my rescue. Speichern!
Jupp!
Geschafft! Und hinaus.